Hello and welcome to a brand new series called Beginner's Guide to Evernote 10. Yes, that's right. It's now time to start showing you how to get set up with the amazing application Evernote. And in this first episode, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to get started with the most important area, which is the notebooks. Because if you don't have any notebooks set up, then you don't have any structure, and very quickly Evernote will become a complete mess. So we need to get some notebooks set up. So that's what we're going to do in this first episode. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on using Evernote, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my brand new demo account so I can show you how to get started with notebooks. Okay, before we get started, let's just take a look at the three types of Evernote that you can use. Essentially, these are the three plans. Now, for most of you starting out with Evernote, I'm going to recommend that you start out with the free version. You want to be testing it out to make sure that Evernote is right for you. But if you're convinced that Evernote is the right one for you, then you can go premium. Now, the beauty of using the premium version is you can try it for free for 7 days. So it's maybe not such a big deal if you do decide, yeah, I'm going to go with Evernote, I'm going to stick with Evernote. Because when you do go in with the premium version, you do get a lot more features. For example, the biggest hang up I see that most people have with the free version is you can only sync up to 2 devices. So that means maybe one on your laptop and one on your phone. And for most of you, that is fine, but you may find that you also have a tablet, or you might have a desktop at work and a laptop at home. You know, it can very quickly, you can bump up to that maximum number of devices. With the premium version, of course, you can have unlimited devices. So it might be worth trying for free, but if you're just wanting to take Evernote for a test drive, perhaps you want to stick with the free version for now. So the business version, of course, is if you're deciding to bring it into your company, and that's a whole different ball game, which will take a bit more to go into at a future episode. So once you've got yourself started and you've got through the startup, I think it feels a bit more of a barrier, and you've got it all set up, ready to go, then you're going to be brought to what's called the home screen. Now, this is the home screen, and I am actually just set this up on the very, very basic premium. I'm not in the premium version, and it will keep reminding you, by the way, that you can customize your home with premium down here. So what do we have in the home function? Well, you can create notes directly from here by just clicking on there, and you can create a note. You have a scratch pad here where you can just quickly grab information. So if you've got Evernote open all day, then you can just grab a note in here. Once you've grabbed it, you can hit the 3 dots there and you can then convert it to a note. And then you've got recently captured stuff that you may have captured through the internet. And so that's really basically all you can add into your home. But what I want to do in this episode is show you the basics of setting Evernote up. Now, the place I'm going to take you to is this section down here called Notebooks. Let's click on that. So you see that I've got here my first notebook. What I'm going to do is I'm going to rename this, and I'm going to call this my inbox. Now, this is just my own personal preference. I'm actually going to do 00 here because I want this to be always at the top of my notebook list. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm just going to call that inbox, and this is going to be my notebook. And this is the number one notebook that I have. So that's set up right there. Now, for those of you who are wanting to just get it, just to kind of take it for a test drive, what I would suggest you start off with is not go anything too elaborate. I'm just going to create a new notebook by clicking on the section up here, new notebook. I'm going to call this personal. So I'm going to go 02 because I want to keep this in order. So sorry, 01 and then personal. And actually, I like to put mine in capital letters. You can do it however way you want to do it. So I've got my personal one set up there, and I'm going to create another new notebook here. I'm going to call this 002. Oops, where am I? O2. I'm going to call this work. So I have my inbox, I have my personal, and I have my work. And so you've got everything that you need right here, and it's all set up. So I've got no notes in here. You can see the note caps in there. So essentially all you need to do to create a new notebook is click on the button right there, which says new notebook, and you can create whatever you want. I'm going to recommend right now, when you're setting up Evernote, you just need to make sure you have one or two notebooks just to give this thing a test drive. That's all you're doing in, say, the first few days. As you grow Evernote over time, you will start to see there are other possibilities. But for now, when you're setting this up to start with, let's just keep this as simple as possible. So going back up to here, we've got our notes. Now, I've got no notes at all at the moment, so obviously there's nothing in there. But if you click on the notes, this is going to show you all your notes. And you can go in here and you can actually sort this by title, date updated, date created. You can also filter here, and you can filter by tags, located in, and so on. So you've got quite a few things that you can do in there, but obviously we have no notes right now. Notebooks we've now covered, so that's how to set up your notebooks. I've got my three notebooks in there. And by the way, you can just use the little arrow here. You can see the drop down there, and I can have them right there. And I can actually create a new notebook right from the side menu. Moving on into something called tags. Now, again, I've got no tags right here, but now tags can be very useful if you've got a lot of notes in, say, your work notebook and you want to name, create projects. And if you're creating projects and you're not wanting to create additional notebooks, then you can use tags. Now, the tags are really, really flexible. I generally use tags very much in the same way that I used a filing cabinet. So I use alphanumeric tags, which means that, for example, one of my favorite hobbies or one of my biggest interests is James Bond movies. So I have a load of tags related to the movies, the books, the paraphernalia surrounding James Bond. I also have a tag related to Ian Fleming. So any articles that I come across related to Ian Fleming, I will put in there. Obviously, productivity is a big thing in my life. So I have a tag for productivity articles that I want to keep. So there's all sorts of things that you can do with tags. And you just want to play around with tags. They're very easy to create and very easy to remove. You can share notes with other people, which we'll do in a later episode. And of course, you've got your trash. And then if you're using the free version, you're always going to be reminded about upgrading to premium. And so there you go. That's essentially the interface of Evernote. It's really quite simple. What I'm going to tell you to do, though, is to start yourself off with setting up a few notebooks. Setting those up first is always going to help you to be able to make sure that you've got things slightly organized before you start. Because if you don't create a notebook and you just have that first free notebook, as you saw at the beginning there, you're going to quickly start adding notes in there. And in the next episode, we'll look at how to get notes into Evernote. And I'm going to introduce you to the web clipper. And at that point, things can get very busy quite quickly. So you want to set up your notebooks first. And that's it. That's really all I want to share with you right now. Now, if you want to go on and start adding notes to it, the very simple thing to do is just click here, click on new note. But I'm going to cover that in the next episode next week. So just bear with me on that one. If you're looking at starting out with Evernote, then get your notebooks set up. Okay, thank you very much for watching this episode. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week.